Hey guys, welcome back to another video today of Playing Might of Haven, and we're gonna look at the new Reborn Evos, so Crystal Altar, the Frigid Dystopia, of course, also it's Reborn Falcon's Destiny, and Grandfather Clockwork. Okay, we're gonna start off with Grandfather Clockwork. I showed you this thing yesterday, it looks pretty legit. It's a little bigger than normal Clockwork. As you can see, it's a little bit bigger and a bit wider, but it does times 19, so it's pretty good. And yeah, why would you want to use this? Let's say you got Quantum Clockwork and this thing and Quantum or Refiner or Polisher, I don't care. We're gonna see what they both give in terms of money. So this gives about 77, this gives 266, so you can see the difference right there. It's way more powerful than this. Okay, that's a little short one because there's nothing really of note there, it's just an item. I'm gonna move into Falcon's Destiny. This is a whole another beast. So, Falcon's Destiny. I'm gonna put next to Falcon's Grasp and just look at it. It looks absolutely amazing. It's a little bit longer, I think. It's a little bit longer than Falcon's Grasp, but it looks way better. I'm gonna grab that. I want it. Ah, great. So when you just look at it, like, okay, I'm gonna show the normal multiplier of it. So this thing, normal multipliers are 3 times and 2.5 times. But when you place down, like an Evo, like if I do this, it becomes more. 12 times. When I do that a little more, I mean 6 times. Well, this frame value doesn't contribute to the thing, give me a minute. Let's do this. The fuck is happening? If I just place these down, does it have a cap of 12? Or 6 times, I mean? This worked when I was testing it like a minute ago. It has a cap of 12. Apparently, it's been changed. Which that's pretty good. Okay, now onto the most intricate item that we whip the page for, because it's a pretty interesting item to say the least. .com/wiki/crystal altar. I have crystal altar right here on the page, and then I'm gonna whip it out. It's a pretty big item to say the least. So yeah, what you're gonna do is you need a mine with ore worth more than 250 trillion. So place down some conveyors and draconic glass, because I can click and then it drops. That's the only reason we're using this one. If you can use like palladium or something. Normally it doesn't do anything. Then if you grab out a flamethrower or a big pet blast or anything, it does. It becomes red. Then you need a freedom bombarder or a permafrost refiner. I don't have permafrost, but I have freedom bombarder. So it becomes icy, like this. Every time you hear a big bang when it happens. Then you'll need robotic enhancer or chemical refiner to make it smoky, so it said. It becomes broken crystal altar. Then you'll need a shredding or any of its counterparts, or a dreamcatcher, or an angel's blessing to give the item particles. I'm just gonna whip out angel's blessing because I have 2 of them. Big flex, I know. You're gonna place that on. It becomes shiny crystal altar. Then you need an ore illuminator or an ore indoctrinator, just like this. Let it work, please. Wait, what? Oh, I've got something. First you need radioactive refiner. Pardon me. I need money. There's a little inconvenience right here. Okay, now we have money, and then we can just whip out chemical. Where is it at? Right there. Radioactive, I mean, not chemical. Fuck, I bought the wrong thing. The whole thing is going according to plan, of course. You're gonna place it right there, you're gonna click the button. If you have Tsar Bomba, I'll just whip it up on screen. You can use that. Wait, why doesn't this work? Okay, give me, I'll just do a little cut. Okay, I got it to work. You need to be lucky for some reason. But yeah, and then you need an ore illuminator or indoctrinator. I'm just gonna use indoctrinator because it's really rare and I have it. I wanna show it off. I'm just gonna place draconic glass down again. I don't know why, page filing or some shit. And it becomes unsealed crystal altar. Shows you the multiplier. Pretty high multiplier. It's like comparable to Book of Knowledge. At times 90,000. I mean times 45,000. It's basically one of the most powerful furnaces in the game, next to Book of Knowledge and Devourer of Nightmares, but I don't own Devourer of Nightmares. You gotta power with a lot of items. And see, she only needs 5 crystal altars of this thing. I mean, crystal shrines. It's a pretty good thing to use in your setup or in your. And when you're like life 3,000 or 5,000 some shit, 10,000, I can imagine you someone using this. I'm gonna show you a way to only have to drop one ore in a straight line, and then it works. We're back. Okay, this is what you need to build to power crystal altar with just a few clicks, and you ne it needs to hit the thing, the teleporter. Otherwise, it's kind of shitty. You just spam this, let it go through all the phases. Wait, I forgot to place some angels. Spam the thing as hard as you can. It's broken right now. There you go. Shiny. Unsealed. There you go. You just build this at the end of your setup and then power it and then just remove all this shit again and then you got a 45,000 times upgrade. So yeah, that's Crystal Altar. Now for the last item, Frigid Dystopia. When I first got the thing, I just basically did this out of instinct. You can see it just gets blocked. That's because she has like smelt the little bar. In asterisks, of course, you can't actually melt it, it just goes through if it's on fire like that. So, this adds 10k to dollars value. I'm gonna reduce it to 5k because I don't want shit. And you're gonna do basic iron mine again. So, the ore is now worth $5,000. We go through 60k. That's times, let me calculate 5,000. That's times 12. And that's a lot, but that's even more than Deadly Spore, right here. This thing does times 7 when it's on fire. Yeah, this is a pretty powerful item. It's life 500, rarity 5, so yeah. Okay, this was the video, hope you liked it, subscribe, drop a like, comment, whatever the fuck you need to do. See you later, bye.